sports. It's in the game.
Talk about you do this and that, ain't none of that done new to us. Acting like that you popped off, no damn way that you grew to us. Been in my own lane, carry you like that dude the truck. Trend following, I'm surprised you just now catching up. It's my way or the highway, baby girl, I'm not a settler. Don't play with my kind, no matter my mind, I promise it get pitiful. They love me, they love me, they love me. I promise I do the bare minimum. My people, they say that I'm underrated, but it's crazy, I'm steady, they killing them. Can't ride by wave, I'm flipping them.
I'm so sick of all of you, weak, weak, lame, lame.
And the opening kickoff will not be returned, as that will be a touchback. So here come the Eagles, the defending NFC champs, led out by a man who was the runner-up to Patrick Mahomes at MVP balloting a season ago. Of course, that's Jalen Hurts.
And we already knew that Hurts was a good quarterback, but last year, he moved to elite status. Under his guidance, the Eagles returned to the Super Bowl and nearly won it. He's also one of the league's most dangerous players, thrown for 38 touchdowns his last two seasons and run for another 23.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts. He'll get this one complete. That's A.J. Brown. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. 11 yards for number 11. So here's a first and 10 at the 38. From the gun, it's Hurts. Over the middle to Smith. Give him a gain of 5 on the completion. And that's going to bring up second down. I think defensively, you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on. And I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that, you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch. Now you put the offense in a position where every series, they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
But first down, Hurts. And the Broncos get there and take him down. Baron Browning from that outside linebacker spot gets in there. It's a loss of 9. After the sack, it's second and 19, and the road gets a bit tougher from here. They will run straight ahead with Swift. A four-yard pickup that gets him going forward, but still 15 yards left on third down. Tall task ahead of him here, needing a full 15 yards to move the chains. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And Hurts is going to be hit and taken down to the ground. They'll make that a second sack here on their first drive out defensively, and not to get ahead of ourselves, but they're on pace for double-digit sacks at this point.
Well, they got to find a way to tamp that down, aren't they? So if you're the play caller, you're telling your quarterback maybe some screens, maybe some draws, hard count, use your voice inflection a little bit, anything to try and slow that pressure down.
Well, the Broncos offense gets set to go to work, and at the helm in his second season wearing orange and blue, Russell Wilson. Now the third-year man back and healthy. It's Javonte Williams. And out of bounds across the 15-yard line. It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Well, you don't turn your nose up at a gain of four, do you? They'll take that on first down. Playbook's got to be pretty well open on second and six.
Second down and six now. Here's Wilson. He'll find its tight end. It's Adam Troutman. And they're able to get this one across the 35. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
That's a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
Shrugs him off. Shrugs off another. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets in the enemy territory. 15 more there, and they're on a roll. It's another first down.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
This could be the start of a nice stand from this defense now after getting walked backwards on this drive. Come through with another one here, and you have them staring at a third and long, and that puts the defense in a position to dictate to the offense.
And he has another first down as they'll get the ball down to the Eagles' 29-yard line. 18 big yards on that one, and a Denver first.
That's the first time he's called his own number, but he's got to be overjoyed with the results. He wasn't just going to settle for a modest gain. To me, he was determined to come through with a big message to a defense that slept on him in the pocket.
And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It'll wind up being a huge loss on the play, and that's going to bring up a second and about a mile here. Off the play fake. Here's Wilson. He rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted. Picked by Kevin Byard. And the Eagles are going to get it back here just past the 35. They set themselves behind the chains, trying to get it all back in one play, and it backfired.
Didn't it feel like a pitcher working his way into a 3-0 count, right? You're behind. What do your coaches always tell you? Get it back one pitch at a time. In this case, they tried to get it back right away, and it didn't work out.
No score after one on EA Sports. Start of the second quarter, and it's the Eagles in possession as they've got it with a first and 10. On the option to give to Swift here, and just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Hurts throw here taken in as he's able to find Goddard. And this is going to be another first down as he'll make the tackle at the Broncos 37. Hurts. He's going to get that to Swift underneath.
So the completion good for 6 yards, and it's second down.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And he'll be brought down at the 27-yard line.
Good reactions there defensively. That screen was a little slow in developing, and they shut that one down with little gain.
Hurts sets up to throw it. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And he is going to have an Eagles first down, and he'll have it by plenty as they're able to keep the drive alive on 3rd and inches.
First down, Eagles.
On 1st and 10, it's Swift. Give him a couple on the carry there. 2nd and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. 2nd and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Eluding the pressure right. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. Hurts dangerous when he runs that football. He's got a first.
They made a nice effort to stick it with a loss for that play, but it's going to take more than that to keep him from advancing the ball. Should be an entertaining battle anytime he tucks and runs over the second half of this contest.
And he'll take this from the 9 down to about the 7.
The yards may start getting a little tougher to come by down here near the goal line. That's good work defensively there on first down, holding them to a short gain.
2nd quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. They'll try again here from the 7 on 2nd and goal. Here's Hurts to throw. And he's going to go down. Sacked back at the 13-yard line. Baron Browning. That is now 2 sacks for him here in this first half. Following the sack, they go from the 13 on 3rd and goal. Throwing is Hurts. And this is going to be incomplete. Good work by that Bronco defense, and it leads to a 4th down. So Hurts is off, and on comes Jake Elliott for the Eagle field goal. This will be spotted at the 20, so it's a 30-yard attempt. The kick by Elliott is good, and we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. So, Charles, they get to them with their first turnover of the game and then make it hurt a little bit extra with a field goal.
And anytime you give the ball up, what's the first thing a coach tells his defense? Don't let them score off of this. You've got to put out the fire. In fact, in 2021, that's what one NFL coach termed his defense. The firemen. Go out there, guys, and don't let them put some points on the board.
So now the 2nd drive offensively coming up for the Denver Broncos. They threw an interception the first time they had the football, only gave up 3 points off of that, so shouldn't be a difficult hole to overcome.
It really shouldn't, as long as they're not listening to the chatter coming from the other side, because when you throw a pick, look, I know defensive backs, they have a tendency to be a little bit loud after they take one away, but they also have a tendency to gamble a little bit more, thinking they'll get a second one. Maybe they can take advantage of that with some double moves.
That's complete to Troutman, right side. A huge play there for Denver, 48 yards.
U.S. tight ends about their favorite routes to run, and surprisingly, this will pop up as one of their staples because they run so many routes in the middle of the field. How about this one? Starts downfield, bends it to the corner, great touch on the football, and they turn that one into a big play.
And now look at this, big game, but a fumble. And it's picked up by the Eagles. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football. Changes hands. They're going to take a look at this just to make sure that they have it right.
Now the question, was the knee in fact down before this ball comes loose? And is the video convincing enough to overturn it?
A lot of factors here. Remember, you also need clear possession.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field is reversed.
So that one overturned. They say the knee was down, and that will not be ruled a fumble. So we've hit halftime, just a field goal separate. Sorry, Coach, we'll catch up with you after the game. We're going to skip through halftime here and headed back to the field for the third quarter.
And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, getting set for quarter number three here.
These offenses seemingly still back at the hotel for the first half. 3-0 our score as the second half gets underway. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. Here comes the Broncos offensive unit here as they'll have it first to begin this third quarter. Charles, it'll be interesting to see what adjustments this offense made in the locker room. Haven't really been able to get anything going offensively, virtually nothing.
Oh, and Nelson's face tackling. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Successful start to the drive, 17 yards, and moves the sticks.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just going to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
Here's second and three.
Wilson now off the bootleg.
Oh, tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Picked by Kevin Byard.
And the Eagles are going to get this back to their own 34-yard line.
And that has to be a little bit discouraging, because after all their halftime talk, adjustments, and points of emphasis, their first drive ends with an interception. Absolutely aggravating if you're a head coach, because you spent all that time, gone through every situation possible, and it still ends in a turnover.
Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Once again, it's Swift. And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard. In the first half, he was held in check on the ground, but despite that lack of production, they still have the lead.
Yeah, and they've got to feel fortunate about that. If they could actually get production from their lead horse, that would help open up this offense and widen this margin, too.
And the tackle going to be made at the 41 as they stop him a few yards short of the first. Decent gain on the scramble to six, but now it's fourth.
That looked great when he first took off, because in my mind, there was room to run, and he had the marker in his sight. But I certainly didn't expect him to close so quickly, and neither did he. They got to him just in time, and now that forced him to make a decision with his fourth down call.
And he is out of bounds right around the 34. A great return there, bobbing and weaving his way for 31 yards. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. They go play action now, Wilson. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Maybe a little frustration starting to creep in. The offensive line has done a great job of protecting him in this game, and there he was, hit again as he threw it.
Yeah, another time on his backside, probably starting to get a little frustrated.
Got to keep his composure. Can't let the defense know that they're getting to him.
Still fighting for more.
And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. 23 yards on the pickup there and a first. If they're going to try to complete this comeback, they need more runs like that from him, because until that point, he's been virtually shut down.
And based on where they are right now in this game, you would expect the ball to be in the air. But his ability to break off those types of runs, you can get big chunk plays on the ground as well. And he just provided one.
And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. That'll be marked as a 27-yard pickup.
I love the drive they're working on here, because they know they can take the lead with a touchdown. And so far on this drive, so good. They moved the ball down the field with very little resistance defensively. But they better be prepared.
And he'll take it into the end zone for a Denver score. Javonte Williams, a 16-yard touchdown run. And the Broncos have taken the lead here this third quarter. Lutz good on the extra point, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. Just a four-play drive that time, and it was capped off by a Javonte Williams touchdown. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And the drive will begin at the 25 as Scott is going to stay in the end zone.
Here's the Philadelphia offensive unit now as they head out to take over possession. And with the way this offense has played thus far, to be frank, they got to feel pretty grateful to be in the ball game.
I would agree with you totally, because they've done all of nothing offensively in this game, yet they still find themselves in a position on this drive where a touchdown can give them the lead. They need to take advantage of it.
They're still looking for that first touchdown here in the third quarter. All they have so far, the field goal. That's good for 21 yards and a first down.
First downs have not come easy, and neither have runs like this throughout this game.
Absolutely not. He finally felt like, whoa, a sigh of relief. We got something going in the running game.
They'll throw on first down with Hurts. This is caught. It's Brown. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
We couldn't ask for much more to this point in the second half. A gorgeous day. One score game. First and 10 here. Swift going to try up the middle.
And running room scarce here. He's going to be stopped in his tracks at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Now back to throw. Complete to Zacchaeus. Will go down as a gain of 6. And now it's 3rd and 3.
Coming up here looking for 3 yards to pick up the first.
Throwing from the gun, it's Hurts. And he's going to lose yardage here. As they will switch ends as time has run out on this third quarter of play. Welcome back now to Denver. It's the Eagles behind on the scoreboard, but with the football here as we start the fourth quarter.
They're going on fourth down with Hurts. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Eagles unable to convert there on fourth. And the Broncos will take over on downs.
Denver offense at the line, ready to go. Their defense forced the turnover on downs. They've got the lead. They're in good shape, but can't go into a shell here, right? Still got to be careful.
Yeah, because they're still a long way away from kneel down time. So they've got to work on getting first downs, keep the sticks moving, right? Keep the clock going, and above all, ball secure. Don't turn it over.
They work now on 2nd and 9. They go play action with Wilson. Open man is the tight end, Troutman. And all the way home for a Bronco score. Adam Troutman, 58 yards. And the Broncos use the big play to extend their fourth quarter lead. Lutz with the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to 11. Pretty clean and simple there. Just 2 plays. The long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number 2. After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off.
And the drive will begin at the 25 as Scott is going to stay in the end zone.
Philadelphia getting set to take the field.
And the script really is flipped for them. The momentum on the other sideline, and now they have to try and battle back from a 2-score deficit.
Off the play fake, here's Hurts. This will be caught by Brown. And they work this well upfield across the 45. 23 yards on the play.
All right, this is the time of the game where they're down a couple of scores. And they've really got to get some yards in chunks. And they know the defense doesn't want to give those up, but they've got to find a way to take them anyway.
Now the question is, can they string a few of those together? Throw right side, caught by Goddard, the tight end. So they'll get 8 out of that completion, and it'll be... Sean Payton not liking that last call. He's going to go ahead and challenge him. Did he keep those feet in bounds? That's the question they've got to decide. And I got to say, watching it in real time, it was... So the challenge there does not go their way. This will indeed remain a completed pass. They go play action with Hurts.
And his throw is incomplete.
Well, he certainly thought he had a window to push that ball downfield, but as soon as he released the throw, the corner was there to slam that window shut.
They'll try and run here with Swift. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. The defense stiffens to force fourth down following that first down gain of 8. They'll try it now with Swift. And he will have a first down here at about the 40. The time to pull out the stops is now, and they convert there on fourth down. So the fourth down conversion sets him up with this. First and 10 at the 40.
And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo.
Second down, here's Hurts.
And it's a fumble.
Oh, one of the linebackers has got him.
And his guys are going to take over at the 34-yard line.
Well, we know he's got the speed to get downfield, Charles, but there's the negative side, a little loose with the football that time.
And that's normal, especially when you have his type of talents, because you feel like you're into the open field, and maybe you don't feel the people who are around you are closing in. All quarterbacks have to do extra ball security drills with the way the game's played now, because defenses, they attack the football as much as they attack the runner. One thing you hope to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air, and I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
The broken tackle couldn't create a ton of space. He'll be taken down just beyond the 35-yard line. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down. Now a 10th carry. Here's Williams.
And now off to the races, down the right side. Inside the 10. And all the way home for a Bronco score.
Javonte Williams.
His second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Broncos have pretty well put it away here in the fourth quarter.
We see this a lot on third and short yardage, especially down here in the red zone. They're going to sell out to stop the run, try and hold them to a field goal. But once the running back gets past the first wave, the resistance can evaporate after that. And he not only picks up the first, but he takes it all the way into the end zone.
Lutz good on the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. The drive there only spanning 3 plays. And it was capped off by a Javonte Williams touchdown.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off.
And the drive will begin at the 25 as Scott is going to stay in the end zone. The Eagles just about set to go to work on offense. Right now, they're in a bit of a tough spot here, CD. You trail them by double digits. Remember the last time out, they fumbled. They're going to have to play some clean football here on this possession.
And all the talk on their sideline has been about taking care of the football, making sure that they're handling the ball correctly. So you know they'll be squeezing the rock pretty tight here. They just have to be careful not to go so hard in doing that that they actually cause themselves other problems. Take care of the ball, but still try and play free and natural.
And A.J. going to pick up an Eagles first down up near the 40-yard line.
So it's Eagle football here as we get you reset. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score.
Second down, here's Jalen Hurts.
Zacchaeus here hauling it in.
6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And this is caught on the sideline. Are the feet in? They are. What a catch.
A very nice pickup of 33 yards.
First down, Eagles.
On first and 10, it's Hurts.
Minutes of the game, this will be blown dead. Only the fumbler can advance the football, so this will go back to the spot of the fumble.
And oh, it'll be intercepted.
Picked off by Pat Surtain, and the Broncos are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20.
Well, I mean, field goals probably aren't going to cut it at this point. This was touchdown or bust, and unfortunately for them, it turned out to be bust.
Yeah, they're feeling like they've got to force the issue here, maybe take some chances they wouldn't have earlier in the game.
Oh, an absolutely filthy joke. He's got some space now, and they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down.
34 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times.
One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. Oh, Wilson gonna throw. And he will find his man Sutton. That's complete. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Corwin Sutton, 57 yards.
And the Broncos are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
And this win now going to look a little more lopsided on the scoreboard, CD. Now, some may have run out the clock in that scenario, but they wanted to put their foot on the gas, get one more touchdown, and they did just that.
Well, partner, I would say the traditionalist not overly excited about that score. They'd like to see the game played a little bit differently. But what you can't argue with is their execution of that play, because it played out exactly as it was drawn up. It almost would have been a shame not to finish with such a well-run play.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off.
And the drive will begin at the 25 as Scott is going to stay in the end zone. Eagles set and ready for their next offensive drive.
They have a little bit of time left here, but this one not going to go their way.
And this is where, in this situation for me, you just go ahead and run out the clock, shake hands, congratulations, and move on. Because now, you're not going to make up for what's happened during the game in this last sequence.
We'll see what they do here in this last sequence. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 22 ticks to go in the fourth.
Hurts. And that one too wide and incomplete.
They lead big, and a major part of that has been how they've taken their play to a whole new level this second half. No points allowed since the break, and you can add another incompletion to the total number that they forced in this runaway contest.
To throw once more on second and 10.
Hurts. A throw here right sideline falls incomplete.
And that's another play that's painted the picture of this game overall. It's been a blowout. It's been continually fueled by big turnovers and stops for one side and an inability to advance the ball from the other.
Now yet another incompletion here as they fail to connect on third. Now the trials and tribulations of being a quarterback in this league, it's tough. It's got to be wearing on him out there.
Well, he has been sacked a number of times. He had an interception, so I'm going to give him a skosh of credit for hanging in there and trying to make something happen despite the amount of pressure he's been under this entire game.
Well, somebody lit a fire under that offense during the break, Charles. Remember, they trailed at intermission. They come out, they have the big second half, and that...